A very good morning class. Today we are going to start chapter 5 division. I'm going to take examples from your exercise 5A so that you will understand that. First of all, what is division? Suppose I have 12 ice creams and I want to divide these 12 ice creams in such a way that each of my friend will get at least 2 ice creams, right? So how I'm going to write this? I will write that this 12 will be divided in such a way that each will get 2. So 12 divided by 2 will be 2, 6, 12. Now this equation which we have got here is known as the division sentence, right? This division sentence can be written in a working form as 12 divided by 2, so 2, 6, 12, and this will be 0. Or this can be written as 12 divided by 2. We will cut this off. 2 ones are 2, 2 six are 12, and answer will be 6. In this chapter we are going to learn about this way. Now let's see what is the relation between multiplication and division. So we have done 12 divided by 2 is equals to 6. Now do you know if we multiply 2 and 6 we will get 12, right? Or if you like, if here you have divide 12 by 2, we got 6. Now if we divide 12 by 6, we will get 2. Why? Because when we multiply 2 and 6, we got 12. So division is a kind of opposite of multiplication. Now let us see a number line in which we can write the division sentence. Now here a number line is given and we have to write a division sentence for this. So how we are going to write it? First we will see that what in how many sections this number line is divided. It is divided into 10 sections. Now these 10 sections have 2 in each group. See this? The group given here have 2 numbers in each group. So we will divide this 10 by 2 and our answer will be 2 5s are 10. So this will be our division sentence for the number line given. Let's take another example. So how many total section do we have? We have 12 total sections. Now in each section, this each section here is divided into the 4 points, right? So we will divide this 12 by 4. So 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, and 4 threes are 12. So we will write 4 threes are 12, and this will be the division sentence for the given number line. Now let us move to exercise 5B. Here we will learn about division by one digit number. Let's take one example. 469 divided by 6. How we are going to write it and what are the basic terms we are using in division? Let us see. Suppose it is 469, so we will write 469 into this we will write 6 outside. Now this 6 which we have written here and this 469, this 6 is known as divisor. 469 is known as dividend. Now let us divide. When we are going to divide, we will see that this divisor and this number is at ones, tens, hundreds place. That means the greatest place value we have. So 6 is greater than 4. That means 4 is not divisible by 6. So we will take two digits together to solve it. So let's divide it. If we take the table of 6, 6 sevens are 42. How we are going to divide? We will take the exact smaller digit from the number we have taken. It should be next smaller to this, right? So 42, 6 sevens are 42, 6 sixes are 36. 36 is also smaller than 46, but 42 is the nearest smaller digit from 46. So we will take 42. Now let's minus this. We will subtract this digit. So we will get 4 here. Now this 9 will be carried down. So we will take 9 here. Now let's again take up the table of 6. So 6 sevens are 42, 6 eights are 48. 48 is exactly smaller digit from the 49. So we will take 6 eights are 48. Again we are going to subtract this. When we subtract, 1 will remain. Now this 1 cannot be divided by 6, so it will remain as it is. Because this 1 remain in the end and it is not divisible, so this is known as remainder. And the answer which we have got here is known as the quotient. So here, the number from which we are dividing is known as divisor. The number which we are dividing is dividend. The answer which we are getting in the end is known as the quotient, and if any number left undivisible is known as the remainder. Let's take one more example. Let's divide 2930 by 3. Now we will see the largest place value here. This is 2 present. Okay, so 2 is smaller than 3, so what we are going to do, we will take the two digits together. So it is 29. Now we will divide 29 by 3 first. So 3 nines are 27. So 3, 9 we will write here and 27 we will write. Let's subtract this. Now when we subtract this, 7, 8, 9, 2 will be here, this will be 0. You can also put cross here. Now this 3 will come down, one digit at a time. We also put down two digits, but that I will tell you in next solution. So 3 we are taking here. Now 3 sevens are 21. 21 is the exact smaller number with by 23. Now subtract it. 3, 2, now this 0 will come down. So we will put 0 here. Now 3, 6 are 18, we will minus it and 2 will be remain. So 2 is going to remain here, 2 will be the remainder. 976 will be the quotient for our this division. Now let's take another example. Now understand it properly. We are dividing 6,332 by 6. Now again we will see the number which is at the largest place value. 6 and 6, they are the equal number. So here we can take the single digit at a time. So 6 ones are 6. We will subtract it. This will be 0. Now this 3 will come down. But this 3 is smaller than 6. So what we are going to do, we will put a 0 here and put this 3 down. When you are taking two digits together, you have to put 0 here. Okay, so I am keeping this 3 down. So for keeping this down, I am putting 0 above. Right, now I am going to divide this. So 6 5s are 30. 5s are 30. We will subtract this. 3 will be here. And this 3 will. Now this 2 can come down. Again 6 5s are 30. So this 2 will be the remainder. And 1055 we will have as a quotient. So you can write that quotient is equals to 1055 and remainder is equals to 2.